In fact, or I'm used to study the non-commutative relativistic Aharonov-Bohm model. However, to find the effects of the radioactive corrections on the Aharonov-Bohm potential, it's necessary to discuss the vacuum polarization of the gauge theory. Therefore, we are led to the non-commutative Young-Mills model. Is the action, and the star represents the non-commutative product, and we choose the tether matrix as this, and this is the diagrams of the self energy, and it's known that this model shows the non-normalizable infrared divergences resulting from the introduction of the non-commutativity. And to solve this problem, Slavnov proposed to introduce a constraint in the action. Which results in the new contributions, these three contributions, and modifies the gauge field propagator, which becomes transverse to momentum tilde. And this is the main point of the proposal, because now the infrared divergences of loop diagrams are cancelled even before momentum integration. This procedure works for infrared divergences of leading order, because these terms are proportional to momentum tilde. But now we are studying the subleading divergences, which, although are logarithmic due to the contribution of the new diagrams and the non-commutative configuration of the space-time, display a mixture of ultraviolet and infrared divergence. And this mixture are not cancelled in loop diagrams, and therefore represent a risk to the validity of the Slavnov proposal. Our next step is try to find a solution for this problem, if possible introducing new terms in the action, and then apply these results to the non-commutative relativistic Aharonov-Bohm model. So,
thank you very much.
Thank you.